Hello, good morning to everyone. Today we will going to start our next chapter, chapter number 3, pair of linear equation in two variable. First of thing, I welcome to again, once again everyone, and I hope everyone is well and healthy, okay? Now is the second wave of the corona is going on, so please be safe, okay, and remain to your home, okay? So now we will start our today third chapter, pair of linear equation in three variables, okay? It is very important chapter also, and we have already discussed a little bit about this chapter in 9th class also. First thing, everyone know pair of linear equation. Everyone know what is linear equation? What is a linear equation? Linear polynomial. Everyone know what is linear polynomial? A polynomial whose degree is 1 is called linear polynomial. If any polynomial we equate to 0, suppose like this one, everyone know 5x plus 7, it is linear polynomial. If I equate to equal sign, then it is become equation. Always remember, whenever in we will use equal sign, it is become equation, okay? 5x plus 7 equal to 0. It is a linear equation in one variable, because variable is only x is variable, so in one variable, so it is linear equation in one variable, okay? Suppose if I write it 5x plus 7y equal to 8. Now it is 5x plus 7y equal to 8. It is linear equation or not? Yes, why not? Linear equation. Linear equation means a polynomial whose degree is 1. It is called linear polynomial. Degree is 1. Yes, power is 1. But there is 2 variables, x and y, so you will say that it is linear equation. It is linear equation in two variable. It is in two variable. It is linear equation. Linear equation in one variable. Do you understand it? So it is linear, it is first is linear equation in one variable and second is linear equation in two variable. So if you want to write it in a general form, what is the general form of linear equation? You can write it is coefficient of x. Coefficient of x you can write ax. It is, you can write by plus it is constant. Constant another side become negative or positive. You can write ax plus by plus c equal to 0. It is a general form of linear equation in two variable. Variable is there x and y variable. One more example now we are taking linear equation in two variable. Everyone know in 9th class we have already discussed them. In 2nd chapter also. Suppose like this one. Next is one more example. Suppose there is the two friends, Ram and Shyam. Ram and Shyam. Ram and Shyam. There is the two friends, and Ram and Shyam both have 30 rupees. How much rupees? 30 rupees. Write the situation in two variable. So how will we write in two variable? Look at. So suppose what we will do in such type of question, what we will do? Let Ram has x rupees and Shyam has y rupees. We know, we don't know, because we know only one thing. Both have 30 rupees. We don't know which one have, which one has how many rupees. But we consider that Ram has x rupees and Shyam has y rupees. So write an equation. So both of, sum of the both of the rupees, x plus y equal to how much? Equal to 30. So it is linear equation in two variable. It is very simple. Understand it? Understand or not? X plus y equal to 30. So it is linear equation in two variable. Understand or not? Now, one more case we will discuss here. Suppose I write, you can write this equation in one variable also. Yes, we will write, let Ram has how many rupees? If Ram is x rupees, so Shyam has how many rupees? Shyam is 30 minus x. Is it true? Yes, why not? If Ram is 10, so how much Shyam? How much have Shyam? 30 minus 10. 20 rupees, same as 30 minus x. So right, both is the rupees. So Shyam, how much rupees Shyam has? 30 minus x, and Ram has x minus, Ram has x rupees. Understand it? Okay. Now it is only just for explanation. It is just an explanation for you. What is linear equation in two variable or one variable? Now look at, dear, suppose I write here one linear equation in two variable. And I am writing here 2x plus 3y equal to 12. It is linear equation in two variable. Variable is x and y, and linear. Linear means degree should be 1. You cannot write 2x square plus 3y equal to 12. It is not linear equation. It is quadratic because degree is 2. Okay. Right. If I ask you, represent this equation in 2 in graphically. It is called algebraically representation. It is algebraic representation. But if I say you represent this equation in graphical, it is x-axis, it is y-axis. Understand it? Represent this equation in graph. Okay. Otherwise, I can ask you, find the solution of linear equation. Solution mean, what value you will put in place of x, any value you will put x, and we will find value of y. It's very simple, dear. You can find. You can make a table like this one. It is x value and it is y. Suppose we are taking x is 0. If x is 0, 2 multiply 0 plus 3y equal to 12. 2 into 0, 0. What is remain? 3y. 3y equal to 12. So y equal to 3 another side divide. If x is 0, y is 4. It is first solution. First solution. Second is, if x is, now suppose you can take now y equal to, you can take, what we will take? If x equal to 6, x equal to 6. If x is 6, then y is 6, 2 multiply 6 plus 3y equal to 12. So 2 into 6, 12 plus 3y equal to 12. 12 another side become minus. 12 minus 12, 0. And 3 into y equal to 0, it means y equal to 0. So y equal to, if x is 6, y is 0. Like this one also you can find. If y is 0, 3 into 0, 0. So 2x equal to 12. 2 another side, divide, multiply. 2x is 6. Okay. Next is dear. Suppose x equal to, any number you can take. Okay. Suppose x equal to
how much you will take? Now suppose we are taking 9. X is 9. If x is 9, so how much y? 2 into 9 plus 3y equal to 12. 18 plus 3y equal to 12. We want to find value of y. If x is 9, then y is how much? 12 another side. Minus 12 minus 18. So 3y equal to minus 6. 3 multiply y. Multiply another side. Divide. Minus 6 divided by 3. How much? Y equal to minus 2. Y is minus 2. Understand or not? Another number you can take. If x is, if you can take now y is minus 4. Y is minus 4. Find value of x. Any value you can put. Either you will put x or you will put y. If we will put y, we will find x. And if we will put x, we will find y. Any value you can find. Okay. We can put 2x. 3 multiply minus 4. How much? Minus 12. It is 12. So 2x minus 12 on the side. Positive. 12 plus 12. 24. X is how much? 12. So like this one. Like this, how much solution we can find? Infinite. How much? Infinite. How much? Countless. So it means represent this point in graph. Okay. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It is your graph. Okay. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. First thing, in third chapter, everyone use graph, pencil and skills. Don't make direct, okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5. Minus 6, minus 7, and here also minus 1, minus 2, minus 8. So like this one, you can represent. First point, what is first point? First point is x is 0, x is 0 and y is 4, because first coordinate is always x. X is 0, x is always 0 on y axis, and y is how much? 4, so it is point. So you will represent it 0, 4. Next is x is 6 and y is 0. Y is always 0 on x axis. It is 6 and 0. Next point, x is 9. X is 9. X is 9. It is 9. And y is minus 2, it is minus 2. So where? It is point minus 9 and 2. It is 9 and minus 2. Sorry, it is positive. It is 9 and minus 2. Now, you can join all these three points. It is by skills, by using of skills like this. So like this. Okay. And we observe that every solution of this equation on line. So how many solutions? Everyone know a line is always made by how many point? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 100, 200, 5. How many point on a line? Infinite. So therefore, a linear equation has also infinite solution. So it is first solution. It is second solution. It is third solution. Same as it is there. Fourth solution is also come on line. Fifth also come on line. Maybe here. Maybe here come.
maybe here come any point you can take dx. Suppose x is 2, now you can take x is 2. When x is 2 to the 4. 4 on the other side minus. If x is 2, so it is come 8 upon 3. So it is 8 upon 3. 8 upon 3 means 2.6. If x is 2, it is 2 and it is 2.6. So it is point. This is name of point 2 and 2.6. So like this one, how many solution of the linear equation in two variable? Infinite. And one more thing, the graph of the linear equation in two variable is a straight line. Always remember, the graph of the linear, you can note down it. It is just an example. So always remember, the graph of the linear equation in two variable is always a straight line. And how many solution of the linear equation in two variable? Infinite. And you can remember one more thing. Every point on the line is the solution of the linear equation. And vice versa. Vice versa mean there is opposite is also. What is? What is its meaning? It is meaning every point on the line is the solution of linear equation. Or you can say that every solution of the linear equation is always represent a straight line. So note down it. Now we will write now some more point. Okay. So note down it. There are some important points of the linear equation in two variable. Always remember, it is general form. Linear equation in two variable. Ax plus by plus c equal to 0. And where a, b, c are real number. It means in place of a, b, c, you can write any number. Suppose like this one. 4x plus minus 7y minus 8 equal to 0. It means a is 4, b is minus 7 and c is minus 8. It is only a general form. Okay. And always remember, a linear equation in two variable has how many solution? Infinite solution. Okay. And the graph is always a straight line. And one more thing you have to remember, every point on the line is representing the solution of the linear equation in two variable. Note down it. Now we will learn what is pair of linear equation. Okay. Note down it, everyone. Now look at one more example. It's just an example. What is pair of linear equation? Suppose we already discussed one example. Ram and Sam has 30 rupees. Now Ram and Rohit has 30 rupees. And difference is, one more thing given. Differences of their money is 10 rupees. Represent it in algebraically. Algebraically mean write in equation. Okay. So what we will do? So same as it is, let Ram has x rupees. Because we want to represent in two variables. So therefore we will take x and y. Okay. Always. And Rohit has how much rupees? Y rupees. Okay. Are you understand why we are taking x and y? Because we want to represent in two variables. So look at. So we will write according to question. What is given? Ram and Rohit has 30 rupees. That means sum of their money x. Ram has how x rupees and it. Rohit has y. Both of the rupees how much? X plus y equal to 30. Yes. Next is differences of their rupee money. So how much? This means x minus difference means subtraction. X minus 1 minus y equal to 10. So it is your equation. There is how many equation? there is two equation, equation 1 and equation 2, and both are in two variable, yes, xy, both are different equation or not, yes, so therefore it is called pair of linear equation. Pair means here two equation, so we will write now two equation, two pair of whose linear equation, it is linear equation in two variable, so it is called, these two equation called pair of linear equation in two variable, in two variable pair, this pair mean two equation, okay, so if I write two equation in two variable, both variable should be same, xx and yy, so therefore we can say that a pair of linear equation in two variable, so now write it its general form, what is its general form, so now look at what is linear equation, pair of linear equation in two variable, so always remember two linear equation in the same two variable are called linear equation in a pair of linear equation in two variable, it is a general form, okay, note down it, no need to be confused, what is a1 mean, suppose 5x plus 8y plus 9 equal to 0, next is variable here x and y, next you can write 6y plus 7y plus 12 equal to 0, so like this one how many equation we can write, infinite, so same as it is, so it means coefficient of x a1, how much, 5, coefficient of y b1, c1 in constant, so therefore a1, a2 and b1, b2, c1 and c2 are what numbers, they are real numbers, real number may be here 0, in place of c1 you can write 0, 0 is also a real number, so it is only a general form, understand it, so till now we already learned what is the linear equation, a pair of linear equation in two variable, in two variable, and everyone know dear, it is very obvious, very simple, everyone know, I have already told you, the graph of linear equation is a straight line, is a straight line, but there is how many equation, there is the two linear equation, and if there is the two linear equation, so therefore graph should also be, there is a two straight line, maybe these two straight line cut like this one each other, maybe they never cut each other, so we will discuss their graph also, okay, so now if you want to make their graph, so how many line we will get, two lines, so it is their pair of linear equation in two variable, understand it, a pair of linear equation in two variable, so from that tomorrow we will start your class regularly, this is just an explanation for a short class, okay, and now you have to attend your regular classes, note down all the examples in your notebook, understand it, because now last few days I was also busy because now everyone knows is summer vacation is going on, okay, that's why, so I hope you understand it, what is pair of linear equation in two variable, I have already taken a lot of time because it just an very simple things, but I took there a little bit more time, okay, I hope everyone understand it. In next class, we will start exercise 3.1. You can do yourself also. Okay, you have to only make the equation. Thank you everyone. Have a nice day. Have a good day.